Okay, Aki Kareem for British Boxers, and we're down here in Trafford at the Viomax Centre, I suppose you'd call it. And we've got none other than Darren Murray with us, who's 2-0, signed up with Longshots. Is that right? So tell us a little bit about how this sort of partnership came about.
Well, basically, when I signed up with, I was with Mickey Helly at first, and met Jason through Simon. I trained with the same gym as Simon, and that's how I got to know Jason and that. Not disrespecting him, like Mickey or anything, like it wasn't working, he was too far away, and Jason was getting me my fights mixed up, and then like I've been inactive for a year because fights etc, you know, I didn't really get really much help, and then came to the tier, I just started training, and then Jason offered me a good deal, and, you know, and Jason's bound to be with at the minute, like for me anyway, you know, especially with Simon, he's going to make a whole new stable in Corby, he's going to make a massive thing, like, yeah, I've had my two fights there, and like Jason's now already got me another two, so it's the direction to be in, so that's when Jason just came and asked, and I grabbed him with both hands.
Yeah, now, people haven't seen your fight yet, you know, your style, I mean, you know, I know that your favourite fight was Ricky Hatton.
Of course, yeah.
And, you know, your style, you try and emulate it in a way, don't you? Front foot pressure, body shots, that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So why have you chosen to go down that route and sort of model your style on as a pressure fighter, for example?
For amateurs, man, I was in the amateurs, and, you know, I got a few Midlands titles and stuff like that, but I weren't like, they didn't, in the amateur game, they don't like the pro game. I was more suited to a pro game, I was aggressive, I would come forward, like, I stopped quite a few of my lads in my amateur days, and obviously, it wasn't happening, I kept getting robbed, and I thought, you know what, this ain't for me, and that, it just came how it came along. I think it's probably where the gym I was from, the guy who trained me, Mark Jones, massive credit to him, man. I only got into boxing because I was really young, I was getting bullied and that, and then now, you know, I'm where I am now because of him, and he was a big, massive fan of Ricky Hatton, and I think that's how he developed me into that style, and that's how I am now.
It's interesting because a lot of fighters I speak to turn over, they say they've been robbed a lot in the amateurs, which is why one of the reasons why they turn over. So do you think that's a bit of a problem with the amateur setup?
Yeah,
then?
Well, it was back when I was amateur, man, but they've changed it now, haven't they? They've done 10-8 rounds and 10-9 rounds. Yeah. If that was back in the day when I was for amateur, it would have been fine, but yeah, I got robbed a few times because I was more aggressive. They were just getting clean shots, that was it. But I was being aggressive, catching them with loads of shots, but they wouldn't count, you know. It's a bit unfair sometimes, you know. But
when are you next out?
November the 1st, Corby Best Western.
Yeah.
On the undercard of Simon and Henshaw.
Simon Barkley, talking
yeah, about Simon Barkley, yeah. So we're on the undercard of that, and they're fighting for, I think it's British Masters or something like that, or something like that, British Challenge Belt or something like that. But it's good to find out. I want to do what, you know, I want to be in there with, like, you know, like when Simon moves on to bigger, better things, I want to be taken over there, like, cause it's my hometown and that. Got some good support, you know what I mean? But it's just hard when you travel, you know, it's hard to travel with support in a minute, so.
It's good to have a fight in your hometown though, isn't it? Because, you know, third fight in and you're getting these fights, these big bills in your hometown, which a lot of fighters have to wait maybe till they get sort of 9, 10 and 0.
Oh, definitely, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's why I grabbed it with both hands with Jason. Like, Jason's the man, like, at the end of the day, I wouldn't have two fights at the minute if I didn't have Jason. Like Jason got me my two fights, I would have been non-existent. And like I said, Jason's the big, he's the one who's getting me on these shows, and he's offered me, when I've signed the contract, he's offering about me not only getting me on Corby shows, but getting me on undercards with live on Box Station, BT Sports, stuff like that. And you know, and it's wicked. Like Jason got me my very first sparring down Gallagher's gym, and you know, I sparred Marcus Morrison. You know, I wouldn't get none of that. Like, you know what I mean? Just walk down the stairs, you get starstruck, man. Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that's all Jason, and Jason's offered me a really good thing here, and you know, and. You know, it was hard with Mickey. You know, Mickey's got a lot of fighters, so no disrespect to Mickey at all, he helped me out, but it wasn't working, so, you know, Jason offered this, and it's how it is, it's good, man.
All right, man, well, listen, it's been great to catch up with you. It's good to have you on, you know, British Boxers for the first time, and hopefully it's the first of many, and wish you the very best of luck in your next fight.
Thank you very much.
And anything you want to finish on, anything you want to say to sponsors or anything
like
that?
Yeah, of course, man. I want to say thank you to all my sponsors, Big Ice Cream, Mr. Whippy. Quantum Printing helped me out loads. My friend's dad, Alan's, he does build carpentry work and all that. I want to thank all them, and people who pay for medicals and just all the support, man.
All right, thanks a lot, Darren Murray.
Thank you.
Really good speaking to you. Aki Kareem, British Boxers. You know the score. How are you?